In this video, I'm going to show you the exact steps and strategies that you need to do on your Shopify store to optimize it for higher rankings and more traffic. We will start with the basic stuffs like keyword research, optimizing your store, etc. And then we will move on to some advanced SEO tips that nobody is actively talking about. But first, I want to clarify something. This is not a quick hack or cheat code video on SEO. SEO is a long-term game. You won't get immediate results with SEO. However, if you implement my exact blueprint step-by-step for 3 months, then I guarantee that your site will surely rank higher and give you a lot of organic traffic. With that note, let's start the video. The main goal of SEO is for your website to be found when someone types in a search term into the search engine and yours comes up. This is what we call search engine ranking. So to do this, we need to optimize your store in such a way that the search engines know exactly what your store is about and that they think that your store is the best result for what the person has searched for in the search engine. For the sake of this video, I am going to use one of my clients' store and show you exactly how you can optimize your store for higher rankings and more traffic. Now, let's get started with the first step, keyword research. Keywords are the base of all SEO, and we're going to go through exactly how to find the right keywords for your store now. So to choose your keywords, I use a free tool called SEMrush. This is arguably the best keyword research tool on the internet and a must-have tool for SEO. And you can get a lifetime free account of SEMrush using the first link, which is given in the video description. Once you create an account, you'll see an interface like this. On the left menu, you will see the option of keyword research. Inside keyword research, go to keyword overview. Now, when we use this tool, what we want to do is we want to put the search term that we think our customer is going to type in when they're trying to find something that's in our store. For context, this is our client store, which is selling kids' bathrobes, towels, bedsheets, and loungewear in India. For this tutorial, I will try to optimize this store for the keyword kids' bathrobes. So simply enter your keyword here. Next, you can select a country. Our target country will be India. Then you can also select a specific city or state to get a more personalized result. And you can also add multiple keywords in this search bar. And then click on this search button. Now SEMrush will give you an overview of your search term. You can see the search volume of your keyword, the keyword difficulty, the intent of your keyword, and the trend report for this keyword. Here, we need to make sure that the keyword has a high search volume and low competition. There's no point choosing keywords that have low monthly searches because even if you do get ranked, there's not going to be much traffic from those keywords. At the same time, we don't want to target keywords that have high competition, as it will be very difficult to rank for. For our keywords, you can see that it has over 3,000 average monthly search volume, and it also has a low competition. Lastly, we want to make sure that the intent of the keyword is commercial or transactional. If all three criteria are fulfilled, then it means that you can rank for this keyword. Next, when you scroll down, you'll see the keyword ideas section. Here, you'll find some variations of the keyword you've searched for. So click on View All Keywords. Now, SEMrush will give a lot of related keywords based on your keyword. Next, we will select 3 to 4 keywords from this list based on the search volume and keyword difficulty. Then we will categorize them into primary and secondary keywords. We're going to choose one primary keyword that we want to rank for, and then we're going to choose 2 or 3 supporting keywords. So let's choose the one that has the most volume that's the most relevant, and then let's choose 2 more that have good volume that are relevant to the main keyword. In our case, the primary keyword will be kids' bathrobe, and the other 3 keywords will act as supporting keywords, also known as secondary keywords. And now that we know what keywords we want to rank for, we need to put them within our Shopify store so that search engines can find them and rank us for those keywords. So we need to put these keywords into our products pages and our collection pages. More specifically, we want to use them in our product titles and descriptions, so that when search engines can easily track them and rank our store for these keywords. We will start with the product pages. So, let's go to our Shopify dashboard and then go to products. Now, as we mentioned earlier, this is one of our clients' store and they are selling various items such as towels, bathrobes, and longwares as well. So, we need to sort these products and find kids' bathrobes. Once you click on them, it will take you to the exact product. This is the heading of this product. We need to put our primary keyword here. Next, we have the description, where we need to put both our primary and secondary keywords. Now, to create an SEO-friendly description, we are going to use an AI tool called ChatGPT. ChatGPT is quite capable of writing high-quality and SEO-friendly descriptions. We only need to provide the right prompt for this, and it will take care of the rest. Now, for your convenience, I have created this prompt that you can simply enter into ChatGPT. Just make sure to replace the title with your own product titles and add your primary and secondary keywords in this section. And then ChatGPT will create a description for you. Then we simply need to copy this from here and paste it to our product description. And you can see that ChatGPT has carefully inserted all the keywords in the product description. Next, when you scroll down, you'll see this search engine listing section. Here, we need to enter a title and a meta description. Here you can see that Shopify has automatically taken the description that we added earlier. However, to get the best results, we need to add something called meta description. A meta description is basically a very short description about your product. These page titles and meta descriptions also appear in the search results. So we need to make sure to optimize them with all the relevant keywords. To do that, we can again use ChatGPT and ask it to provide a short and concise page title and meta description. Make sure to add your primary keyword into your page title and meta description. You can also use some variations. For example, instead of kids' bathrobe, we've added kids' hooded bathrobe as it is more relevant to the original product. But make sure that your primary keyword is available in the URL handle as it is. And then make sure to save all your changes. Before we move on to the next step, we have a bonus tip for you. You see, most people optimize their title, descriptions, and meta descriptions. However, one thing that they often ignore is product images. And this is where you have the opportunity. There is something called alt tags, which you must add into your images. The alt tags are basically a label that we can put into these images to tell the search engines what the image is. Search engines can't interpret what an image is right now, so we need to tell it. So we need to give it a description so that when it takes a copy of that image, it knows exactly what it's about. And then it's going to rank you for it. Here's how to add an alt tag into your image. First, click on the image you want to add an alt tag in. Then on the right side, click on Add Alt Tag. Here, we need to type in the keyword plus image specification. Now, we need to make sure that every alt tag is different from one another. For example, in this image, I can add an alt tag, kids hooded bathrobe front. Then for the next image, I can add something like kids hooded bathrobe back. You can also mention size and colors in the alt tag section. Once you do this, Google and other search engines will understand that each of the images is slightly different, but they're still related to that one keyword. Now image alt tags are super important, and it's really going to help your site rank. So take the time and the effort to update all the image alt tags on your product pages. And you need to repeat the same process for all of your product pages. All right, now that we've added the title, description, meta description, and alt tags, it's time for us to optimize the collection pages as well. In fact, optimizing the collection page should be your first priority. You see, when you do a Google search like kids' bathrobe or dog food or anything like that, you'll see that Google is promoting collections into their search result, which means that if you really want to get in the search results, your collection pages should be well optimized. With that note, here's how to optimize the collection pages. On the left-hand side, click on Collections. Here, you can see that we've created collections based on different categories of products. So click on this kids' bathrobe collection. Now, optimizing your collection pages is much easier than optimizing a product page. Just like we did in the product page, we need to add the primary keyword into the collection title, then add the secondary keyword in the description and meta descriptions as well. To do that, we will again use ChatGPT. We simply need to tweak this prompt a little bit, and then ChatGPT will provide an SEO-friendly description for the collection page. Personally, we recommend short descriptions for collection pages. And don't forget to add meta description as well. And once it's done, click on this Save button to save all your changes. All right, now that our products and collection pages are optimized, it's time for us to optimize the homepage of our online store. To do that, go to Online Store and then go to Preferences. Here, we need to add a title and meta description for our store. This will appear in the search result if someone searches for your store name. Since we are selling multiple items such as towels, bathrobes, bed sheets, etc., we will add our description accordingly. Next, we need to add an image here. You can add your store logo here. Next, we want to set up Google Analytics on our store so that we can analyze the store traffic in detail. To do that, click on this Setup Store button, and then install this app to set up Google Analytics. And with this step, our basic Shopify SEO is finally complete. Now it's time to talk about some advanced steps that will boost your search engine ranking even further and push your store to the first page of Google. So, the next step is to boost your Shopify store speed. Faster websites not only improve user satisfaction, but also increase your chances of ranking higher in search results. Since we are already using Shopify, we don't need to worry about the technical stuffs, like compressing images, minifying CSS or JavaScript files, etc. Shopify takes care of all these stuffs itself. In fact, if your store is hosted with Shopify, you won't face slow loading speed anyway. However, there are three key elements that you need to focus on to boost your store speed even further. First, make sure that your store theme is mobile responsive and fully updated. Next, make sure that you aren't using any unnecessary apps into your store. Using too many Shopify apps can affect the loading speed, so make sure not to use any such apps. Lastly, you need to make sure that there are not unnecessary images available on your store. You see, when it comes to e-commerce, every store comes up with new offers and discounts. Store owners highlight those seasonal offers using banners and slideshows. And once the season ends, they simply remove the banners from the website. However, many Shopify owners only remove it from the front end. But in the back end, that image, banner, or slideshow is still stored with other images of your store. And we need to remove them from the back end as well. To do that, we need to go to our store dashboard and then go to Content on the left. Next, click on the Files option. Here, you will find all the images that are available into your store. Now, select the images that are no longer needed into your store. Then click on Delete Files option to remove them. Follow these three steps and your Shopify store will go from this to this in no time. All right, now let's move on to the next step, which is to create a content cluster. Search engines reward you if your site is active and constantly updating, and the best way to do that is to create blog posts. But posting a couple of blog posts is not going to take your site to the top overnight. That's when creating a content cluster comes into play. A content cluster is a group of web pages that cover different aspects of the same topic, to show both people and search engines that you're an authority on the subject. There are two types of content in a content cluster. First, a pillar page that covers a broad topic. Second, there will be some cluster pages that cover specific topics within the pillar page. All these pages should be interlinked to show search engines that you've thoroughly covered that specific topic and that those pages are related. This helps you establish authority, which gives your pages a better chance of ranking in the search results. Now, to come up with ideas for blog posts can be pretty hard, but I use a tool which is called Answer the Public, and it gives me hundreds of ideas for blog posts. This is Answer the Public here. Simply type any keyword here, and it will come back to you with hundreds of ideas for different blog posts. Then you only need to create content around these topics. And make sure to interlink every post with the pillar post. This extra step is so powerful and can significantly boost your store ranking in the search results. With that note, let's talk about the final and one of the most important steps of Shopify SEO, which is known as link building. So what exactly is link building? Link building is the process of getting other websites to link to your website. Every website or online store contains two types of links: internal links and external links. Internal links are the links of our own website, whereas external links are the links that redirects anyone outside of your website. This is also known as backlinks. Now, when it comes to SEO, we need to focus on getting as many high-quality backlinks as possible. This is a very important step because it signals to search engines that others see you as reputable and worthy of being ranked. The traditional way to build backlinks is to create linkable assets, such as blog posts, infographics, etc. Normally, people do guest posts and email outreach to other websites to gain some backlinks. However, these are the methods that were working a couple of years back. But in 2024, there is a new way to build backlinks that nobody is talking about. And once you understand this, you'll be able to create hundreds, if not thousands, of backlinks every single month. I call it link building automation. And the first step of this strategy is to create a referral or affiliate program. You see, most of the big brands have their own referral or affiliate program. What this does is, it allows other people to promote your brand with their friends, relatives, and with their social media handle as well. Whenever someone joins your referral or affiliate program, they'll get a unique affiliate link, which also contains your domain address as well. And when they promote it to social media or on their website, you actually get an indirect backlink. This is a really powerful way to build high-quality backlinks. And the best part is that you don't need to actively work on it. You only need to set up an affiliate program in your store, and then do some emails to potential influencers or website owners. Not to mention that you'll also get more sales and higher conversions if you have an affiliate program running for your store. There are many product reviews and comparison websites available on the internet. You can simply reach out to some of them and offer some exclusive discount for their audience, and they'll be more than happy to promote your brand. This will increase your domain authority and overall rating, which will make your site more reputable and trustworthy in the eyes of search engines like Google. This was our 5-step blueprint that will help you rank number 1 in the search results. Remember, SEO is an ongoing process that requires continuous monitoring, analysis, and adjustments to ensure your Shopify store remains optimized for search engines. It's also important to measure your site performance on a regular basis. Make sure to perform regular website audits, track your organic traffic, and your keywords performances. You can use a tool like SEMrush to perform your SEO operations. SEMrush will help you with your website audit and health checkup. It will track your keywords performances and also provide you with high-quality keywords. Not to mention the link-building features that will help you build high-quality backlinks. You can get a free forever SEMrush account using the first link which is given in the video description. And if you want a personalized SEO plan for your own website, then make sure to book a call with our team using the second link which is given in the video description. Thanks for watching this video.